you know, in a lot of cases, I think back to when I ran internship programs myself, it was almost really kind of 50-50. If you're really having interns doing the work and at the same time they're learning, then this new guidance really doesn't help at all. Because I remember back to when I was with an accounting firm, they're doing it, particularly during the winter internship, the accounting students are doing actual accounting work at the same time they're learning, so they're getting both here. And so I don't see how this, and Mike, Heather, to kind of what you described there, I don't think this makes it easier for employers at all, because this is obviously going to, this is going to be up to interpretation by individual courts. And if you have a employer that has locations nationwide, then they got to choose one way or another. Am I going to pay or not? And even then, it may not be helpful.
State law may affect it as well.
It could. But then one of my big questions as I've really noodled this whole thing is what would be the value to an employer of not paying? Especially considering, I was looking back at some NACE survey data. It was like 97% of employers surveyed said they would pay 98% of their interns. So it's already common practice to pay interns. Who's going to stop doing that first? And I can't see entire industries do that. So I could see maybe small companies doing that, but then that would put them at a disadvantage to larger companies that would pay. And another part of that survey said that students who were in paid internships were more likely to receive a job offer than those that were not paid. So again, who's going to stop paying, and for what benefit other than saving costs? And if part of your goal of having an intern is to recruit them, then you could be putting yourself at a pretty serious disadvantage if you've made that choice.